And that's just a really beautiful house right there. Hello everyone, I'm Donnie Bennett from Blackstone Ocean Properties on the east side of Providence, and just got done with another successful home inspection. And so I'm here to bring you a little real estate 101. Today's topic, home inspections. Just so you know, when every realtor goes to get their license in their licensing class, they're taught a phrase first day. It's called caveat emptor. Caveat emptor, let the buyer beware. And so when you're buying, you gotta be on your toes. When you get into a contract to purchase a property, you've got a right to a home inspection. So that's real estate 101 right there. Get your home inspection as fast as you can. You have a 10-day period there, 10 business days. So these tips should help you hopefully navigate that process a bit better, especially when you're not as experienced in buying or selling real estate as some others are. First thing is, just because you know your home inspector is gonna provide you with a report after the inspection is done, does not mean that you shouldn't show up to the home inspection. You should be there. That is one of the cardinal rules of doing this, is that you wanna make sure you have your eyes on, let the buyer beware, have your eyes on so that you can absorb the information, process it, digest it, and hopefully either change course if need be or know that you are in fact on the right course. Any good inspector in fact will insist that you are at the home inspection. So you should try to make sure that you account for the fact that it could be 2 or 3 hours in some cases. In the case of a larger property, upwards of 3.5 to 4 hours. Number two, while you're at the inspection, ask questions. That's what you're there for. The inspector is supposed to give you as much insight as possible into the mechanicals of the property, the electrical, the plumbing, the roof, the foundation, the heating system, everything that comprises the functionality of the property. And they'll find the negatives, the positives, and whatever is in between, so that you can then assess whether or not you need to make some sort of list of demands with the seller in order to conclude the sale, proceed with the process. Number three, the utilities. Not every property will have the utilities turned on when you do the inspection. This is kind of crucial. You need the utilities on in order to have a proper inspection. How are you going to test the electrical outlets, the polarization of the outlets, if there's no electricity turned on? In most cases, you have a multifamily where maybe one or two of the units are not rented, and so the utilities are turned off, but actually that's some of the cases. Most cases it's because it's a bank-owned property, and so therefore no one's living there, no utilities, and the burden becomes the buyer's in certain circumstances to get those utilities turned on in the buyer's name before they own the property. So you should negotiate that or know that up front, because you don't want to find that out on inspection day. More times than not, inspectors are backed up, they have a lot of work going on, and you know, that inspection date is getting closer and closer to the deadline of your 10-day inspection period. So make sure you know in advance what your timeline is, and know in advance if the utilities are on or off, because it's a disappointment when they're off and you have to do a bunch of extensions and so on and so forth. Number four, new construction. Just because a property is new construction doesn't mean that it's perfect. You should absolutely still consider having a home inspection unless you're a professional in the business. Most people aren't, but if you have a new construction and you find problems, you can then address them. If you don't do the inspection, you won't find the problems. They cannot be addressed. You're buying it as is. The fifth tip for home inspections, tips for buyers, is hire a specialist. Your home inspector is like your primary care physician. They're coming in to give you a general synopsis of what may be an issue with the property or what may not be good with the property. And so once they discover those issues, it's your job to then get the specialist that goes along with that problem. So if it's an electrical situation, hire an electrician, hire a plumber, make sure they're licensed professionals. And then they come in and they can assess further whether this is an issue that can be easily remedied or if it's something that is going to need a lot of money to be invested in order to be fixed. Because you do have home inspectors that are what we call alarmists. They like to, you know, they like to ring the bell because it proves their worth and value. And not all inspectors are like that. There's some really great inspectors out there that are just even keel, and they say it how they see it, and they actually know what they're talking about. But you know, you've got to make sure that your backup has a backup. So those are some great home inspection tips. I hope that they'll come in useful or handy if you're going to be buying a house. And if you're planning on buying or selling, I'm looking for buyers and sellers. Reach me anytime for real estate in the Ocean State, 401-383-4400. I'm Donnie Bennett from Blackstone Ocean Properties. This has been Real Estate 101. Call me anytime.